Welcome everyone to round two of this recording. This is a special Syndicates and Secrets side tale. Rather than take part in the Reign of the Empire, we find ourselves during the Clone Wars on the planet of Felucia, where a group of clones shot down in the middle of the mushroom forests, far from their squads, remains. Pilot dead in unknown territory. Introduce yourselves.
My character's name is Pinpoint. He looks like any other clone, except he has a cloak.
And I'm playing the character Ravage. I'm an ARC trooper. And I have a blaster carbine.
I'm playing everybody's favorite shiny Salvo with a rocket launcher, the carbine, and a bag full of frags.
And last but not least,
Nada, who's a veteran.
And you've all crawled out of your shot down gunship. Your pilot is dead. You are in the middle of Mushroom Forest, away from your main force of the ATTEs led by Jedi Ayla Secura and Commander Bly. You were on your way to rendezvous before you were shot down, and now you have to make it back there on foot. What would you like to do?
Yeah, how are you holding up there, Shiny?
Any landing you can walk away from is a good one, huh, Nada? Oh no.
He's probably still wearing off the explosion. He can't hear anything.
Oh no.
I'm gonna look for some high ground. Is there a mushroom I can climb, or a slight hill?
Give me a... Well, before you give me anything, now that we have our character introductions, you may be clones, but you still have a destiny ahead of you. What do you mean the destiny pool needs to be reset? All right.
Any landing you can walk away from is a good one, Ravage.
Okay, wow, this is really broken. Okay, clear pool, force player update, roll for your destiny.
Perfectly balanced.
Too dark, too light, too light. What will Selfo get? Flip one.
What?
That's not
come on.
Right.
It's on the
why?
Left. It's on the left. It says roll destiny.
Not it either.
There
we go. Well, that feels appropriate. That feels appropriately deserved.
Should I roll for you?
Yes.
Yes.
More light. All right, and you may give me a perception. There is no feasible high ground around you, despite being in a large mushroom forest of Felucia. None of them seem stable to be able to climb.
Okay. Could I start trying to get our bearings and figure out in which direction we need to go?
Yeah. That would be a...
Oh, it also be a bigger. Get a bearing.
Would that be a perception, or is there a survival skill? I forget.
There is survival.
Yeah, survival.
Yeah, so roll me survival.
Would expert tracker help with this?
What does that do?
Remove black die per rank of expert tracker to find tracks or track targets. Decrease time to track a target by half.
I would remove a black dice for you, yeah, so you roll first.
Cool. Aww.
Okay, now, Ravage, if you were also rolling.
Eight.
You do not know which way to go. You can hear the sound of distant fighting, but it is kind of all around you.
And we don't have a general direction we were heading.
You were heading... That I can give you, actually. You were heading, before you crashed, you were moving as the ship kind of is already in this direction.
As I'm walking over to the pilot's corpse, could I, like, kind of look around and get a sense of direction? Roll of survival?
You certainly may. Two successes. You kind of look around. You can definitely see pathways previously marked by clone machinery heading this way. You don't know how far from the rendezvous you are. With this survival, you also all, or at least Nada, you make note that, you know, if you try your comms and try reaching Commander Bly or anyone, you notice that your comms seem to be not fully operational.
No, that was the thing I was gonna try.
Okay, so we don't know, like how far we are from the rendezvous, but, like, do I know, how far, like, we're not above this many clicks kind of concept?
You can definitely, if you hightailed it, you can definitely make it to the rendezvous before nightfall.
Okay, yeah, Nada would, while taking a knee by the corpse pilot, he would point in that direction and be like, no more than nightfall that direction, like, if we, you know, hustle about it.
Agreed. Keep up, rookie.
Hi, sir. Nada. Oh, sorry.
Hi, sir.
And Salvo will follow in haste. If I could get Salvo to move.
Pinpoint is going to intentionally hang behind the group just a little bit to, one, cover our backsides, and two, to be in range if anything pops up.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Pinpoint, give me a perception, please.
Uh-oh. I don't like that.
As... Okay, now who would like to give me... Okay. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do a straight luck roll. This will not count towards your destiny. Whoever would like to be the lucky person to roll destiny will decide something.
I'll do it. Nice.
Okay.
Nice.
We're rolling good today. In that,
the light side, as you guys are walking, it is too late. You know, maybe you guys are, let's say, we'll put you here. You guys are walking in the direction. It is too late to really be able to run or set up any defenses by the time you guys hear it, but as you are moving forward, you hear an ever-closing sound. Let's see if it plays.
We've got incoming.
I was gonna do a once-over of the dead pilot's body before continuing. Could I still do that?
Roll the loot.
You can do that after the Aklay is dealt with.
Fair enough. Oh, I know what these things are.
As an Aklay bursts from the mushroom forest with a screech, and you will roll vigilance. The stalking Aklay.
Do I get to use those?
I didn't. Wrong thing.
Not for your initiative, no.
I will let anyone who goes before me use that advantage from my previous roll.
Let's see if my other music will work.
I hear music.
Why is it so delayed on my end? We are missing a PC in the turn order.
I forgot to click on my character before I rolled it. I'm sorry, it's been a minute. There we go.
Alright. Three PCs go before the Aklay.
What are we saying is acceptable movement for it? We're just gonna do like six blocks?
We'll say 6 blocks goes okay. From increases in increment. Right now you guys are within short to medium distance.
Okay. Is there still any kind of elevation? Or still not any kind of elevation?
Not really any elevation.
Okay. Well, pinpoint is gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and shoot at the Aklay.
Alrighty.
And I'll use my own advantage.
Alright, so you are giving yourself I believe it is blue die per 2.
Blue die for 1.
Ah, so how many advantage did you get?
Just the 1.
Okay, so the difficulty
I also have true aim times 2.
Okay.
So I can upgrade that combat check twice.
Alrighty.
Set?
It is set.
Nice.
Your shot blasts into the armor of the Aklay, and you are able to wound it as it lets out another.
I can also add 3 damage from that because of another perk I have.
Ooh, okay. Alright. And is that all for pinpoint?
Yes.
Next PC.
Okay, go ahead.
Sorry. Seeing Pinpoint and his like blur of cloak like rush past and then shoot behind me and hearing, you know, a whole bunch of stuff going on behind me. Nato would like use his movement to essentially like barrel roll into his like buddies here and then quick draw his rifle and fire at it.
Okay.
Where is my skills again? Oh wait, no, I need to do my actual weapon roll. There we go.
That okay. Does not hit the Aklay. Your shot goes wide.
Right, with the momentum of the barrel roll. Fair.
Alright. Last PC before the Aklay.
I would,
So anyway, oh.
Hearing this Aklay coming towards us, I'd spin my way around Nada and then fire.
Okay.
It's my carbine. That's two advantage. Of course it is.
And again, the blast just goes across the armor of the Aklay and doesn't penetrate its armor. As the Aklay will go next.
I'm gonna tell, hey, Shiny, don't miss. And that's an advantage to him, two of them.
And he's gonna come up to you, Ravage. And he is going to bring down his large claws on top of you. Let's hope this works.
Jesus.
Holy crap!
That's nothing like the simulations.
Yes.
That is 15 reduced by soak.
Are you alive?
You do not die if you go above. You have to double your wound threshold to die. Otherwise, you are knocked KO.
And yeah, I'm still up.
Alright, you're still standing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the Aklay charges in, bring down its large claws, your first taste of Felucian wildlife, and it rends you as we go to the final PC.
Yeah, Salvo's starting blasting. Okay. We just blasting.
Alright.
Alright.
It's, for me, too.
Let's see. What's the biggest gun I got? Look at that. Okay, we ready?
We ready.
Alright.
Nice.
Well, even without the blue die, I guess.
Oh, yes. That is correct.
Oh.
Roll again.
Rolling again.
Okay.
I included the blue dies. Try again.
Rolling again?
There we go.
Dies.
Hey. There.
Alright, we'll take that last one.
The blue die didn't even do anything.
But we'll take that last one. As
that's all shiny.
Is injured by the shiny. PCs go.
Alright, pinpoint is once again getting a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And take another shot. Does anyone have some advantage they'd like to give me?
It does. I do not believe so.
Okay. Well, I still have the 2 from True Aim, so.
Alright, let me throw that on there. It is good to go.
Ooh.
Okay.
And the +3 for my brawn, and I will be using those two. Wait, what's the inflicted critical injury thing again?
You need to match your critical rating to be able to trigger a critical.
Do I need 3?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I see it right there, critical. Okay. Do anything with those? I will add a black die to the creature.
Okay.
Creature's next check.
Next PC.
I'll go if no one minds. Nada will take a couple of steps back, kind of like slowly walking back, and take another shot at it.
Alright, go for it.
There we go.
Nice.
Alright. You are able to land a nice shot into the Aklay. Next PC before the Aklay.
I'm gonna dodge roll my way backwards and then fire.
Okay.
Because attack of opportunities aren't a thing in this,
they are not
right?
A thing in this system. Alright, you can trigger a crit.
I am definitely going to trigger a crit.
And Pierce goes through soak, right?
No.
What does Pierce do? Pierce goes through
armor. Yeah.
Alright.
I think it ignores one for one, I think.
All right, and you are
Breach
going to
the one that ignores both armor and pierce.
Right, you are going to trigger a critical. I said trigger and critical together. Let's see what happens to the Acklay.
Oh well,
that's kind of
it has a fearsome wound.
Fantastic.
All right,
not a very useful one.
The Acklay's gonna move up on the shiny, but he has a black die to his attack, and he's going to bring down his fearsome claws. I will be kind.
Later.
And not trigger anything.
Nice, that scene.
Damn.
I will be kind and not trigger anything.
I told that kid he shouldn't be talking about his girl back home
Although
like that.
Although it would be really funny to kill off the shiny immediately.
We were gonna go cruising, man.
I will not do that. However, that is 15 damage reduced by soak.
Why'd he show me a picture of his kids, man?
Are you still...
And armor, right?
What, yes. What do you have to add for mine? Because I have ranged and melee defense.
You're gonna keep your damage, but we will fix that when we get to the next combat.
Good. Okay.
Okay, so... Let's see. What do I punch in here? I just start rolling death saves.
Are you knocked to zero?
Let's see.
What is your soak?
Three.
So 15 minus 3 is 12 damage.
I'm running on 1.
Okay.
Oh, so you're fine.
Last PC fine. Turn.
Walk it off.
Which is you.
Sure.
Ravage is over there on 1 HP. You don't see him bitching about it.
It's your go, Salvo.
Get up off the ground, Shiny, and shoot that thing.
Run away.
I mean, I don't blame you.
I'm getting the hell out.
Okay, you're just booking it.
I'm flat booking it. I'm not shooting it. I'm just
All
booking
right.
it.
Next PC.
You might ought to move your character.
I'm working on it.
I think that's an acceptable distance. I will take another shot at it with my plus 2 die. And my
All
2 blue die.
Right, it is up there.
Alright. And the plus 3 from Ron.
Okay. Next PC, if there's nothing else.
So, at this point, Nada will, activate his jetpack and fly up around it.
All right.
How much movement do I have with my jetpack, to be fair?
It is still normal movement. We're considering 6 squares to be a maneuver, so you can go 6 squares. Well, I'll say I'll give you another maneuver, I believe, for free, so you can do 2 zones of 6 squares and then attack.
Okay, Nada will fly 6 squares up, and then, 3 squares over to here.
Okay.
So he's, like, up and kind of, like, you know, like a distraction, right? And then, he'll try to take a shot.
Alright.
Nice.
Nice indeed. It is looking very rough. Your blaster bolts are getting through its armor. Next PC.
I'm gonna move back a little more. Take a shot.
Oh, he's leaving the rookie.
What? No.
Take your shot.
Okay.
Alright, you take your shot. It is looking rough. Let's see.
I'm gonna give the 2 advantage to the next one.
The Acklay, I'm gonna roll something for them.
complete speedy hack while you're trying to decide whether or not to just run.
I'm gonna roll. This is what I'm gonna roll. The Acolyte does turn around after taking too much heat and is gonna turn tail. Alright.
Pinpoint is going to run down to Salvo and yell to Nada.
Help me!
Nada, keep an eye on it. Stay aimed on it. And I'm going to try to make a medicine check.
Alright, you're not stabbing a med pack into him?
Oh yeah, what's the difference between the med and the stim packs? Because we have...
They're the same thing.
Gave us... Oh, they're the same.
Stim packs is what I meant. Same thing.
Can I use one of mine on him, and then he can use his own?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that.
So, 5 HP. I have HP. Those?
Yep. Yeah, because we're doing the whole 5, 4, 3, 2, and then a new one, right? Okay, yeah. Yeah.
So you are healed 5 HP, Salvo. Is anyone else planning on shooting on the Acolyte as it's turning tail and running?
Not unless it turns around again.
I was gonna make that thing eat rocket.
If
you aimed, I would put my hand up and put your rocket back down. And like, not really like try to push it away, but I'd like shake my head no.
Now's not the time, Rookie.
It's turning around. Let it leave.
Nada would come over like comms and be like, "Are you sure about that, Captain? If we don't make it to the rendezvous by night, we don't want that thing coming back."
You go to go over your comms and all you hear is static.
Would you like to yell that?
I mean, you're right here.
Well, I don't know if you guys would hear me over the jetpack.
Well, what's the plan? Are you guys firing on it? If you are, we will stay in initiative. If not, it will end up running away into the mushroom forest.
If I see anybody aim, like look like they're about to fire, I would say to leave it alone. It's a wild animal, and it's not going to come back. And we won't be here when it does, if it did.
Okay.
Well, I would also agree with the sentiment. Now is not the time.
Well, then we will leave the initiative as it runs off into the mushroom forest, leaving a battered clone squad.
As it runs off, I stick a stim pack in myself and say, "Let's get moving."
Okay.
Not I would, come back down and land next to the party. Walk with them.
Once again, Pinpoint would fall to the rear, and he would be looking extra alert for that Acolyte to come back. Like he's aware of everything else, but he knows what he's looking for now.
Mm-hmm. Give me another survival.
Who?
You.
Both of us? Okay.
Pinpoint.
For fuck's sake.
You can hear distant sounds of the Acolytes, maybe more than one, screeching, but... When you hear the screeching, you can hear also distant blaster fire. They may not be on you, but you know they're out there in the forests.
Here's hoping they're on some clankers.
Hopefully those things find the clankers.
Anyway, we have a direction. We need to get moving.
Think we'll be safe in the humongous fungus?
How long have you been waiting on that?
He's been waiting
since my audio went out.
Oh my god.
He's been holding on to that one since he was birthed in Camino.
Shinies.
Okay. You guys begin moving forward. Who is leading the front? It is Ravage, right?
Yeah, I'll be up front doing the same thing that Pinpoint's doing in the back.
Okay. One moment, please, as I set things up. Give me a survival.
Eight.
You begin walking, and again, you can hear sounds of the Accolades. You're following tracks of clone machinery and footprints. Eventually, you all find yourselves in a village that you can see simple barricades set up. You can see some blast marks around, but no sign of your fellow clones.
I wonder if anybody's home.
Ravage, want to check out these buildings while the other two keep watch?
Yeah, I can do that.
Well,
I'll go over here.
With me, I meant.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would preemptively stow my rifle, and I would pull out my pistol.
I'm doing the same as well, yeah.
Alright.
Is there, like, a high point structure? Like a guard tower or, like, a tall building?
Give me a perception.
Okay, give me just a sec.
On second thought, Shiny, go to that communications array, see if you can raise the rest of our battalion.
And the perfect thing with that, Nada, you see the tallest building would be this antenna, this array over here.
Alright.
See, we're clear this one if you two can clear that one and then get that array up and running.
Nana will look over at Salvo and be like, hey, Shiny, you any good with communication arrays? I'm better with the rifle myself.
I do booms, not comms.
It's all wires, isn't it?
I could help you with a smoke signal.
Ravage, you're already hurt. Let me take point. And I'll step in front.
Copy that.
Okay. So while Nada and Salvo head towards the array, you go to open this door. Would you like to do anything before opening?
Nope. I have my pistol up. And I'm about to push open the door.
Alright.
We're sort of in our breaching formation, so...
Yeah, they're stacked
the
up.
And you find...
I dart in.
You find nothing immediate inside. You do find some blast marks. There don't seem to be any bodies.
Is that a staircase?
No. For the purposes of this,
okay.
No. You do find blast marks, signs of fight in this house, but you do not see anyone.
Is there any kind of equipment that would be useful to us at this time?
Give me...
Yeah, maybe.
Is there an investigation? I always forget. Or is it perception?
I think it's...
No, isn't it?
Well, roll me a perception.
Yeah, I think we've been using perception.
You do find a data pad. There's not much equipment, but you do find a left-behind data pad.
What'd you find, Pinpoint?
Not a jump jets towards
data
the comm.
Okay.
Any idea what's on it?
Well, I try to...
And Salvo will follow.
You, while they are walking towards the array, you boot up the data pad, Pinpoint, and on it... It must be a data pad from the locals who were caught in this war. It reads that a group of clones came, took over the village for defense, set up a comms array, but then the droids started bearing down and they had to flee the village before they were destroyed.
Apparently, there was a clone unit here that had to evacuate. Is there anything else of value on this datapad?
It just seems to be mostly a diary. Give me a computers. It does say you are in luck. This datapad would belong to one of the builders. One of the other like entries you can find is brings up that the whoever lived here, the clones had help set up the array, and it tells how to set it up and turn it on and repair it.
We need to get that over to them.
Like a smile on us today. Now start walking.
Oh. Yeah, it seems like there's nothing else here. As we're walking, I'm gonna pop another stem. All so right. Add 4 to my health.
And while you guys are doing that, Nada and Salvo, what are you doing?
I guess Nada hits the like button to open the door. With like the butt of his gun, you know?
Mm-hmm. And again, just like the previous building, inside you don't see anything. Actually, what you do see, I will give you something. In this building, once I set it up, lying against one of the doors is the left behind destroyed remains of a B1.
Nada will, like, look over at it and, like, look back, seeing Ravage and Pinpoint coming down and back this way. Be like, there seems to be a damaged B1 in there. Other than that, I'm not really seeing much of anything.
Pinpoint here found a data pad that has information on setting up that array. As I just make my way over. I assume he does too, but he's not right here right now.
Nada will leave that to, like, pretty much everyone else at that point, and then we'll, like, step back from under, like, the overhang or whatnot, and then we'll just jump jet onto the top of the roof and, like, take guard position.
Alright. Anything from Salvo?
Need a hand with that, Ravage? As he walks over to the comms array.
Yeah.
Alright. If you guys are going to begin repairing it with the help from the datapad, you will get some blue dice. You may roll a computers. Whoever.
Computers or mechanics?
Mechanics, actually, yes.
Anyone else better than 2 green? I don't think. Yeah, are you? Good. You could roll that then.
Okay. You are able to... Some time is spent. You are putting together this destroyed comms array, but you are able to get it up and running. The little antenna begins moving around in a circle.
Need to hail Commander Bly. And get a location. So I guess that's what I do. I'd radio in, Commander Bly, can you come in? Over.
At first, it's still choppy, you know. As you begin...
General Sakura.
As it begins kind of turning... you do eventually hear... The first thing you hear is sounds of heavy blaster fire and sounds of battle. As you hear a voice, Commander Bly,
Soldier, where are you? We're surrounded. We could use some reinforcements.
We're in a village that I assume you guys were in not horribly long ago when our ship crashed on the way in. We're headed your way. We need coordinates if you can give those.
Send them now! You hear him shout to another cloak. Keep your heads down! A couple seconds go by, you get the coordinates. The rendezvous is not far from you. But you do get back from Bly. I'd find some cover if I were you, soldier. We got reports that there's a tank crew on the way to that village.
Copy that, Commander. ARC Trooper Ravage out. Heads up, gang. We got a tank coming our way.
Is there any way we can set some... Is there any way our demolitions guy can set some explosions for it?
I am the explosions.
All right.
Considering away we go that way, I put explosions up that way.
The splitty boys over here.
Ravage, want to clear out this last house real quick?
Copy that. On your six.
Down to the house.
Okay.
Boop.
You find nothing inside.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Well, this would be the best location to fire in a tank from. Farthest back, anyway.
Give me a perception, please.
You say me?
Yes, please.
Okay, perception. Beep.
You can see, while the others are moving around, going between buildings, while Salvo is setting up, from your location, from your point of view, you can see in the distance, the way you came, actually, you can see mushrooms being barreled over. And you can see the barrel of a tank. Specifically, an AAT.
Do we still not have comms?
Comms are now repaired. They have been brought back up by the array.
Alright, he would come over comms and be like, the direction from which we came, there's something coming. Or an AAT.
Salvo, do you have any anything that can temporarily short-circuit it?
I just have stuff that'll blow up to smithereens. How's that sound?
Well, it is better than nothing. Not sure how much blasters are going to do against it.
Is there any... Can we get on top of this mushroom?
Oh, yeah. Good point.
Could jump down on it.
You could certainly try before it gets here. Nada would have been able to see that. It is bearing down. It is going to be here soon.
Nada, if we distract it, can you get on top of that mushroom and jump down on it when it gets here? We can try to take over that tank.
I can definitely try. When I look through my scope, do I see any ground troops with it?
You would have spotted 4 battle droids along with it.
Alright, he'll say that he sees, 3 battle droids. You said 3, right?
4.
4. Right, I was gonna take a shot at one.
Hey, Salvo, I would take another stim while you have the chance.
Right, Salvo's gonna take cover by this, house to the left, and punch into the stim.
Alright, and you're taking a shot at one of them?
Yeah, he'll call over, comms of AC's 4 battle droids with it. I can take that shot now.
You can take that shot.
He then goes, no, 3. I see 3.
And yes, that, we will say that that crit, despite missing, the crit will kill one. And I will reveal...
It, like, hits, like, a weakened, like, mushroom that, like, falls down on it and then, like, crashes.
Rocket time!
It takes this one down as the droids all shout, "Contact!" And we will do our turn order as the tank comes into the village.
Cool.
Cool, surely.
Yes.
All right, we're prepared.
You are prepared.
All right. Not a chill.
Hey,
holy.
There's all our PCs. We have one PC up first. Who's going?
Take that rocket shot.
Salvo is ready to roll. Okay, we got rocket time. Rocket time.
Alright, you're taking a rocket
shot. Alright. Taking a rocket shot.
Alrighty.
Here we go.
Right, somehow right past the tank.
Pinpoint?
Do you even pass your training?
Yeah. Unless you want to move, Pinpoint's going to go next.
I was just
might have had a waiver.
So.
Anything else, Salvo?
Might have had a waiver.
I can throw a grenade at it. Salvo is going to tactically retreat.
Okay.
Behind the house.
Alright. Next PC.
Pinpoint is gonna go here ish. That's line of sight. Yeah, that's line of sight. I'm gonna shoot at that one.
At the
try
B1?
To drop that droid.
Alright.
Yep. And I have my 2 die.
Yes, you do. It is ready.
And
you drop a droid.
Sick. I will add a black die to the tank.
Okay.
And I will also, because I think that was 3 movements.
Move back down out of sight.
Yeah. I'm just 1, 2, 3. Okay. Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Okay. The tank is gonna go.
Uh-oh.
Don't mind this.
This wasn't me.
Don't mind this, boys. As the tank takes its sights on the two of you, and it is going to fire with its anti-personnel weaponry.
Do I get partial cover from this, like, bridge thingy?
You're not getting partial cover from anything.
What about this tree that's in the way?
Nope!
There's 2 trees.
Something,
actually.
Anything!
I have ranged defense.
For purposes, I'm gonna say that's probably not gonna help against the tank.
We'll hide behind the plant.
Wait, I have plot armor.
Alright, it's not its worst weapons. It is just its simple anti-personnel. It could be a lot worse, but here are its anti-personnel shot.
Wait, you didn't add the black die.
From? Oh, yes, that is true. Let me redo it.
Okay, that's better.
That's a little better.
So, 8 damage minus soak. As boom, boom. The AAT fires down into you as it blows up the surroundings and you take the damage as we move to the next PC.
Salvo's gonna climb on the tank.
You've already taken a turn this round.
Oh. Disregard. Carry on.
Yeah, wait your turn.
Do any of us have, like, grenades on us? Or is that, like...
I do.
That is up to you. I mean, you guys could have taken grenades if you wanted, but if you didn't, you didn't.
Right, I didn't actually. Okay. Fair enough. Alright, let's see here.
What's this barrel, by the way? Is that anything?
Flammable, it's like.
Are there interactables?
Get the tank over there and
spend a destiny point, we can say it's flammable barrels.
Oh, it's not my turn, so.
Well, saying that there's like a barrel right here, right?
Do you want to spend a destiny like one to call right here? Flammable?
I will.
Alright, spend that destiny and you got some flammable barrels next to the tank.
I'm gonna go ahead and try and shoot one of those barrels.
Okay, this is gonna be a harder shot because the tank's in the way.
Fair enough. Oh! I have elevation.
Mm-hmm.
Is my current elevation good enough to...
That will take away your black die.
Excellent. Okay.
Nice.
Combat. Okay, so,
shot.
Right. Would the party be mad if I spent another blue dice, or destiny point to... have a little advantage with a shot?
Nope.
Okay. So I'll spend another one.
Alright.
Let me know when to roll.
You are spending another one. It is ready to go.
Really? Okay. Well, that's lovely. Wait a minute. I will spend those two advantages. Where is that at? A nearby power conduit discharges into the target. For two advantage, I can, ignite stuff or whatever.
You mean perform a free maneuver? Oh, no. Your perk.
There's multiple things that you can do with advantages and triumphs depending on your environment and the situation that you're in. There is one for, like, the wilderness that is, like, igniting, flammable, like foliage and stuff. Can I do that same kind of concept with the barrel?
Sure. We will say that you can fire at the barrel and a small flame begins to spark towards the barrel. It is not going to ignite, but should you strike it and it does ignite on its next attack, we'll say it will do an extra 3 points of damage to anything around it.
Right. That'll be my turn.
It's ready to blow up, but it's not there yet.
That is not true. I have one more thing. I will go over comms to Salvo and be like, I think we can probably get those barrels to blow. It's already starting.
Okay. The next NPC, the droids, are all gonna march forward and take their shot at the Rocket Man. Mr. Salvo, you have two blaster rifles firing at you. And miss. They strike the side of the building and do nothing as we go to the next PC.
Now that's plot armor.
I'm gonna peek around the corner, seeing the fires and hearing the comms about the barrels ready to blow. I'm shooting at the barrel right next to the tank.
Alright. Alright, you hit the barrels. The barrels go up in flame. Alright. You kill one of the droids next to it.
Nice.
And the tank. Let me look at the tank here. You see a large chunk of metal crushed inward in the tank as you take out a good portion of its right side, but it is still hovering and it is still bearing down on you with its weapons. It is sparking, it is flaming, but it is up.
Move backwards around the building.
Okay. Next PC.
Pinpoint is going to charge the tank. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And he's gonna, that's 5 spaces. He's gonna try to climb on top of it.
Okay. Give me a skill. I know there's an acrobatic skill, isn't there?
Athletics.
Athletics. Give me an athletics. You can certainly climb on top of the tank.
Okay. Do I take a strain from that threat?
I will. The flames and sparks are kind of making you sweat underneath your armor, and you'll take a point of strain as you can get on top of the tank.
Okay. I'm going to use my action to take another maneuvers and get out of the range, like out of the cone of its firing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do I need to make another athletics to get up, like, to here?
To get onto its main barrel, I will say yes.
Okay, is it ready?
Yep. Alright, you are able to get up, same thing. These sparks that are flying are making you sweat under that armor.
Alright, I'm on it.
Alright, next PC.
Salvo's gonna take out that B1.
Try not to blow this thing up while I'm on top of it.
Alright, taking out the B1. Go for it, Salvo. Rock your attack whenever you are ready. Alright. You take down the last B1 battle droid. All that's left is the tank and its crew.
Tank may be a little damaged now, but hopefully we can take it over if we don't destroy it.
Okay. Anything else from Salvo?
Nope. We're good.
The tank is going to turn. Oh, no, I don't want the flames, too. You can go away, please.
Oh, are we supposed to see flames? Oh, those are the flames, I see.
The tank is gonna turn towards Nada's building and the communications array. And Mr. Pinpoint, give me another athletics as it's beginning to turn.
Oh, God.
You stumble backwards, but don't worry, you don't fully fall off. You just land back on its main front forward section.
Nice. Yeah, come on.
And the tank is going to fire its heavy mounted turret at Nada. Eight damage minus soak, Nada. And it is PC turn.
Is that a cycle? No, I went second, right?
That is a cycle. We are back to... No, it is not his turn.
Because, yeah, Nada or Ravage. Okay.
Nada will, like, gaps from, like, you know, having this thing nearly, like, completely hit it, you know? And then, you know, lean over. And now, from the damages that it took on this side of it, was any part of the armor removed? Is there anything that is currently exposed, like a vulnerable point?
There is a large hole in its hover section.
Nada is gonna try to, like, shoot at that and see if he can maybe, like, hit something vital.
Okay.
Where is... Pew, 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 pew.
I'll give you blue dice for this.
Oh, sweet. Wait, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yay, I actually hit. I will use the 3 advantage to activate my critical.
Okay. This is the first time we've ever seen a vehicle critical. I do believe they are different. So let's see what happens. Alright.
Nice.
As Nada fires into the tank, Pinpoint, you wobble for a bit because the hovering of the tank fully disengages and goes limp. And slams into the earth of Felucia.
Sick.
Anything else from Nada?
Nada will, like, jetpack onto, like, on top of where the gun's at. And, like, triumphantly say something along the lines of, "And that's how you take down a tank, boys."
Okay. It would have been really funny if your answer to my question there would have just been Nada.
I thought that's what you were going for.
Alright. PC, we're on the refresh. PC.
What is it to double move again? You can go ahead, I was just curious.
It's 2 maneuvers.
Okay.
I will yell, I'll go over here, and I'll yell over to Salvo. Salvo, toss me a frag, or run over and toss me a frag.
I got you, and I'll throw him a frag. As I run over.
Alright, we can say that, well, we're still in initiative. But we can say that takes one of Salvo's maneuvers when it is his turn to toss you a frag.
Sick. Or actually, Nada's already up there. Nada, catch. And I'll toss Nada the frag.
Okay, so that'll be your maneuver.
Yep. Throw it down the hatch.
We're still, like, I don't know if I can do anything.
Well, that's my turn. And we've looped, so.
We have looped, so next PC.
Oh. Okay. Nada will take the grenade and, like, fly over to, like, where the hatch is at and, like, press the button to open it and go to drop it in.
Alright, Salvo, can you roll a frag for me, please?
I will give an advantage to that. From my previous roll.
Okay.
Okay.
Stonks. Alright.
Oh boy.
Just roll your rocket. How about that?
Here we go again. It's always me tonight. Let's see.
Combat is over as you guys ditch the tank and it goes up in flames with a loud boom.
I will immediately be using a stim on myself to heal 4.
Okay.
It's 5 the first time, right?
I already used...
On yourself. It doesn't matter if you use it on somebody else.
Oh, nice. And 5.
Yeah, if 5 the first time, then 4, 3, 2, 1.
I will use one.
You get a rest, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I assume resting is not going to happen. I'll go ahead and use another one.
Alright. Ravage, you have those
coordinates. Well, that went well. Yeah, I've got the coordinates. We should get moving as soon as possible.
Yep. Don't need more clankers showing up to try to salvage any of this or investigate.
Come on, rookie.
Yep. On the way.
Alright. Let me make sure I don't accidentally copy the tank because it is a very large object.
Nada will look over at Salvo and be all like, I remember my first tank kill.
30 seconds ago, actually.
Moving on. One moment, please. As the sounds of battle begin growing louder and louder, you see your clone rendezvous, your ATTE, surrounded by droids. You are managed to come up behind a grouping of battle droids, but you see Aayla Secura, you see Bly, you see a bunch of other 327th clones surrounded by droids. Maybe, just maybe, it is your chance to turn these tides. As we will immediately get into combat.
Where are we?
You are...
We're down here.
Here.
Bottom right.
There. Okay.
Cool. Because we didn't exactly stumble onto this.
You did not stumble onto this at all.
Man.
Cool. Okay.
And everyone else is going to be cool as well because they're already a part of this fight. The V2s. We have the clones. All go on one. Then we have Bly. Then we have
not forgetting this time
the B1
because of my ranged and melee defense.
Yes, I will calculate all of that into this fight. As I roll for the horde of clankers.
Is there a reason the lines are doubled? Or is that just a
map is a Google map. Shout out to Map Guffin. Go actually buy their maps. Don't be a schlub like me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hey. Never mind.
Where are my V1s? That's not who I wanted. I opened the wrong sheet. I have, spoilers, 50 health worth of B1s here.
Ah.
Just like the simulations.
Just like the simulations. Let me give them their HPs.
The simulations didn't prepare me for how much I would miss my tank.
Mm-hmm.
It was right. Warm in the tank.
Now I'll roll for the B1s. Okay, who do we have first? We have an NPC. We're gonna have Bly go. He's gonna shoot at this B1 right here. With his blaster pistols. And he takes one out. PC turn.
Commander, we've arrived.
Pinpoint is...
Are you
going?
I was going to, but...
Nope, go for it.
You hear back. It's about time you arrived. Give us a hand here.
I'll peek around the corner of this mushroom and fire at the B2 in front.
Alrighty. You see this B2. Alright, you fire into it. You blasted some of its back armor, splashed, and it swings its arm cannon around.
And then I duck back behind the mushroom to give myself another ranged defense.
Alright. Your clone companions are gonna fire into that same B2 that you just shot at. With the might of many clones, because they're all considered one minion group.
Holy crap!
And bye-bye. They destroy this B2.
They take advantage of that distraction.
They take great advantage, and they drop that B2. NPC turn. These droids over here are gonna fire at this clump of troopers with their blaster rifles. And they take down two. Two clones fall. Okay. Make sure that's correct. Alright, next NPC turn is going to be this B2 super, who's going to move up and fire on this clone here. With his trusty integrated wrist blaster. Watch those wrist rockets!
Watch those wrist rockets!
And he misses. PC turn.
I got it. Pinpoint is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4... 5, 6. One second, I need to measure this. Would you say that's definitely in my range, right?
That is definitely long range. Yeah, that is a far shot, but you can still do it.
Okay. I'm a shoot at that one with my sniper rifle.
All right.
And don't forget my blue die.
Yep, let me throw that on. You get two, right?
Yes, two blue die.
Alright, it is on
there.
Do
any of the clone troopers want to give me advantages?
The clones will give you an additional advantage, and they will also give an advantage to the next PC.
Nice. Okay.
What the fuck?
Oh, crap.
Well, you don't hit.
You can... You can do a lot with
that. I should
be
able to do a lot.
Yeah.
Let's see here.
Like, that's almost better than hitting. And, like, if you, like, look at all the things that you can kind of do with, like...
So many black dye, you can make them drop... Well, no, you'd have to hit them to make them drop a weapon, but...
You can give a shit ton of black dice to their next check.
You could have knocked down one of these, like, mushrooms altogether
on
and had hit you damage.
Ooh,
yeah, like, you can manipulate the environment with that many, like...
Can I just give this entire group a black die?
Yeah.
Or like however many black die that turns into.
You can give them three black dice.
5, 6. Yeah, so this Super Bow Droid and these two. Well, I guess you can't really differentiate it, can you?
Yeah, because the B2s are rivals, the droids, the B1s are minions. So all the groups. B1s are a large yeah. group of minions. So you can either give the B1s two? As a whole. Yeah, you can give the B2 two black dice and then the group of B1s one of them.
That is what I shall do, and then that's leftover advantage for the next PC.
All right.
Or NPC, if Ayla Secura wants to do something.
She, just imagine she's just protecting her clones. I did not have the time to actually give her stat block. If
fine.
She
she's
was
anyway.
Part in this fight, you guys wouldn't be doing anything.
Exactly.
So, one of the things you can do with three advantages in mass combat is... the acting force disables an important piece of enemy hardware, destroying a heavy weapon or item of the equipment that provided the enemy force an advantage in the battle.
That's if you deal damage, though.
No, that does not require a hit.
You'll have to send what you're reading, then. Because you're reading something different.
Just a sec, I'll send that to you.
If it is the advantage in triumphs for three advantage, yeah, when dealing damage to a target, have the attack disable the opponent or one piece of gear rather than dealing wounds or strain.
Yeah.
I'm looking at the mass combat advantages.
I am not looking at that. I do not have that.
I'll send that and we'll have it for
you. Yeah, for now, you will do the black dice. This B2 yep. is going to go. He will have two black dice on him. He's going to fire into the grouping of clones in front of him. Two black dice against him. And one more because of the cover as well. He fires and yes. misses.
Nice.
PC turn.
I'm hoping to see a despair. I don't think we've seen a despair yet.
So we have Nada and Salvo left, I think.
Yep.
Before we go back to top of the round.
Correct. Rookie, get in there and do some damage with your rocket.
I just posted what I was looking at in Syndicates and Secrets.
Alright, Salvo, you taking your turn?
Salvo will take his turn.
Alright, you gonna blow shit up, or you shoot?
Rootin' tootin' ready for shooting. Take a pot shot at this battle droid.
Alright. Take your shot when ready.
With the blue die from the clones and from...
Didn't need
that
it.
That was correct, so we'll just add one more damage in. And you take out two of the droids. Because that's how minion groups work. Even if you say you're firing at one, you're firing at them all.
I can't complain.
Alright, anything else from Nada?
Oh, I didn't even see this chump here.
Or Salvo, anything else from Salvo, my bad.
Nothing else from Salvo.
Alright. I need to be removing some NPCs, I believe. So next, PC, last PC, who was up?
I think that'd be me. I will, pew pew pew. Move down this way, and then of course take a fire at this one, but like, you know, all of them.
Yep.
Beep.
Nice.
You are able to remove these two droids in front of you.
I would like to activate my critical as well, so yeah.
So here's the fun thing with that, as you, so we're gonna say you blast up in with your jetpack, How does your critical kill every single B1? Because if you activate a critical on a minion group, it kills all of them.
Dang.
Well, let's say then I didn't, like, shoot, like, these ones or whatnot. I just, like, shot at, like... Like, I pinpointed, like, which
your
ones...
Your like, targeted every single
one. The central net, the one that's, like, the leader or whatnot that's controlling the others.
Yeah, and you blast him, and the other droids just entirely shut down, leaving nothing but the B2s left.
Well then I, if that's a next PC,
that is
I'll
next
take
PC.
The next.
I will give him my remaining advantage.
Thank you. I'm gonna move over a little bit to have a better shot on that B2.
Alright.
And so that's 3 blue die in my favor.
Alrighty. Okay. This B2 is looking pretty rough. It is still standing. But if that is all, Commander Bly is going to fire at it next.
Nah.
Here goes Bly. Some more damage. Next NPC. This one up here is going to fire into the clone group. With its integrated, and he takes out 2 clones. The group of clones are going to fire down at this one. Set them up. And they kill it. PC.
Oh, what is it? We get a maneuver and an action, or if I took strain, I can get another maneuver?
Yes. No, I believe if you take strain, you can get another maneuver.
Okay, so I can double maneuver up to the top and then shoot at that B2.
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna do that. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And shoot at the B2.
Okay.
Do you get any advantages?
You will get the advantage from those clones.
Okay, here we go.
Crit him.
If he's still alive, I'm critting him.
He is still alive. And he will take a crit.
What?
We flip a light to the dark. That's a weird crit.
What?
Oh, wow, that's a really weird crit.
Surely
that's
supposed
not,
to be
right?
The reverse.
Yeah. So,
surely that's supposed to be reverse.
That is very odd. All right.
What?
Next PC.
Are we looped? I guess we've looped.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, we still have Salvo and Nada. The 2-1.
You went.
The 2-1 is the loop.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, I see.
Nada or Salvo, who's taking this?
Nada, just fly straight in the sky and take a long-range shot at it.
Okay, I mean, fair enough. Nada will, do that. Why not? Yeah, okay. He'll move 12 spaces directly up and then go to take a shot.
Alrighty.
That did not work out as planned.
You are gonna take some strain as we move to Salvo's turn.
Salvo will double maneuver up to here.
Alright. Is that all? You gonna rock it?
I'll try.
Just mark down that you took Point of Strain to double move.
Alright, Point of Strain. Okay. Alright, and rocket time.
That rocket does not like you. You know, I want to see the damage it's gonna do, though. So here's what I'll make you a trade, right?
I should have said it earlier. I have 3 advantage. Oh, no, I spent it. Never mind.
I will make you all a trade.
Trade deal.
To hopefully see trade. This damage. I will let Salvo launch another rocket. In trade. There's only one enemy left. In trade, all 5 light side points go to me.
Okay.
Yeah, why not?
I'll do it myself.
Alright, and you know what? You will get all of them as well. Salvo, go for your rocket again.
All of them for advantages too.
Don't fuck us. Yes!
Oh, the B2... is blown to smither fucking reeds with a loud
29 damage.
Do you activate your critical twice?
Yeah, do it.
All right, let's see. Right. Let's see the crits. We'll see.
Double crit.
We'll see what the crits do before we go into narration. Let me come here. Open the B2, go to critical injuries. I believe each one is offset by 10, so.
Oh, damn.
So one of its arms just goes flying off. Its limbs just go flying everywhere as it explodes.
That winded one is awful.
And the combat is over. You can still hear fighting in the distance, but it is you and the rest of your squad now.
Make my way over to General and Commander.
Salvo, do you what make your way duties, over sir? As well?
I will.
Reporting for duty, General.
Ayla Secura says,
"It is a good thing that you arrived when you did. We were trying to make our way forward when we got surrounded. We must take stock of our situation. Now, Bly, the rest of you that showed up, please follow me."
She begins kind of walking off a little bit into the mushrooms as the rest of her clones stay behind.
Take stock.
Yeah, take stock. Nada, do you follow?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
She told us to.
Good soldiers follow orders.
Good soldiers.
That's dark. I know the context behind that. One moment, please. While I look at someone's skill list. Okay. Can all of you please roll me? And you better believe you're not going to get to use any of them because I get to use all of mine. I'm just going to Don't mind me.
Roll.
Please roll me, all of you, disciplines.
Oof.
Holy crap.
I knew it. Oh, is that a... That's a despair, right?
Yes, hey, it is.
I got one of those. Yeah.
All of you hear over your comms, and you see Bly pulling out a little hollow. You all hear...
Execute Order 66.
And your guns turn on Aayla Secura, as that is where the game will end.
Oh, look, I failed.
Oh, look, I missed on purpose.
Oh, look, I missed.
The game...
Oh, despair, I actually shot myself in the head.
...is over. You have turned your face. Weapons on Aayla Secura. Where this clone squad goes in the future is anyone's idea. Maybe they work for the Empire to this day in the main campaign. But for now, thank you everyone for playing this short game. And see you next time on the main campaign of Syndicates and Secrets. That'll be the next time we play.
Which will be soon.
Which
TM.
Will be soon. Maybe. You know, maybe... These clones are aboard that Star Destroyer in the Stormtrooper armor, but we won't know until we find out in that next session. But for now, say goodbye to YouTube, friends.
Bye. Bye, YouTube.
Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye, YouTube, and may the Force be with you.